Tremendous, public response to Beatles, for instance. been some about a year ago, I was in WNCA one night, and they started playing this thing about Paul McCartney being dead. And the next day, in school, you know, all they were talking about was Paul McCartney being dead and everything. And I don't think, like, not many things in the last decade have affected us so much as the Beatles. Like, you know, when I was that age, by today's standards, I would have been like a super faggot. But, you know, today they've influenced, you know, the whole music world, and they set the precedent for everything today.
Do you think they've affected your change?
I don't really think they've affected me much as singularly, but rather the whole, you know, group of people, the country, and that's not me personally, but the things that evolved from them. I don't think any one person, but as a group, you know what I mean?
Thank you for calling. Hello, you're on WMCA.
Alex?
Yes.
I just thought I'd tell you about how they affected me when I was nine, when they came out at first.
Mm-hmm.
And I got my first album when I was 11. And, you know, during the time between 9 and 11, they didn't affect me at all. As a matter of fact, I resented.
Is that like getting your first pair of long trousers?
Yeah, I guess you could say that way, you know. And then, you know, I resented them. You know, I hated Beatles cards, and I hated the fact that the girls were out buying them and everything. And then, you know, after a while, I began to, you know, think at home and everything. And I picked up Revolver when I was 11. And at that time, Rubber Soul was out, and so was Sgt. Pepper. And I really, you know, enjoyed it. And after that, I got up the money to get Sgt. Pepper and 99 cents. And I really, you know, appreciated them. They turned me on to music.
Thank you for calling. PL9-1000 is the number. Hello.
Hello, Bennett?
Yes.
I'm talking about the Beatles because when I was about 13, they were nothing to me. Nothing at all. And now they're everything. They're just so much in the world today. The Beatles have changed a lot. And now if the Beatles said something, now people would know, you know, because the system, everything, they've changed everything. I have medium with long hair, and the styles have just changed because of them. Wouldn't you think?
Well, I would probably agree with you on that. Do you think they changed the whole style, our whole style of living? Do you think they were responsible? Do you think that they made the change, or the change was going to happen and they were simply a reflection of it?
No, I think it was mostly centered around them. Because we weren't doing nothing. We were just standing still in music at that time, actually. And they started things up. They started this change, this revolution we're going in now.
Thank you for calling. Hello, you're on WMCA.
Hello.
Yes.
Hi. Like when the Beatles first came out, not when they first came out, but like in 1965, and I was about 10, and I remember that like four girls and myself, like we'd always, you know, go around in my backyard and play my albums, and we'd always want to, like, you know, sing along with them and everything, and between we were the Beatles, and like I'd always want to be Paul because I really loved him, I still do, and like when Sgt. Pepper came out, I really didn't know that much about the Beatles. And I kind of lost interest in them. But now, like, in the past year, it's now a whole day of Beatlemania for myself now. And, like, everyone in school kind of avoid me and stuff because, you know, that's all they talk about is Paul and the Beatles, and they're really fantastic. And you're really great for doing this.
Thank you.
Okay,
bye-bye. Hello, you're on WMCA.
I want to talk about the Beatles. They made a lot of changes on me. I was about 8 when they first came out. And I had a crew cut then, and I really dug their hair. So I wanted to grow my hair long, but my parents wouldn't let me. So it was a couple of years before I was able to get long hair. But they also made a lot of other changes in me. I think they really got me interested in music. Before that, I really didn't know anything about music. They got me interested into other rock groups, and they got me interested in becoming a musician myself. Like, right now, I'm playing the alto saxophone, and I'm teaching myself to play the guitar. And also, you know, this love for music that I've developed because of them has caused me to take up a job as a DJ at my school radio station. So I think they really made a lot of changes on me.
Thank you. Hello, you're on WMCA.
Hello, Alex?
Let me ask you a question.
Okay.
Do you think we could call the Beatles an era? I mean, do you think that that's right to call it that?
Not yet, because I don't think it's over yet.
You don't think it's over yet?
No.
Mm-hmm.
You see, because Beatles records are still selling. I mean, even you can sell Beatles 65 records. You can sell Meet the Beatles. You see, last year for album the first time, it was called In the Beginning. Did you see that?
Yeah.
I didn't buy it now, you know, I feel it's like a lot of corn. I only like what they write. But anyway, you haven't got down to the economic values yet, you know? Do you realize how many lunch boxes and loose leaf folders they've sold? I mean, remember, you see bums on the street now. They just started writing drawing Beatles faces, and all of a sudden they're millionaires. Another thing, the Beatle cards?
Mm-hmm.
You never heard of them?
I never had any.
Well, I got a million of them here. And I swear someday I'm going
to... Do they say anything on the back of them?
Yeah.
Read me one.
Okay, can you wait a second?
Yeah.
I don't have it for me. All right, hold on.
He's got to run to his drawer right under the Jefferson Airplane cards, which are right on top of the Grateful Dead cards, which are right on top of his American flag cigarette papers. Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
I got one of the color cards here. Okay. The second comes out. It says, question, do you worry when your fans, when you see a mob of screaming female fans, that says Paul speaking, I would worry more if I didn't see a mob of screaming female fans. Screaming fans don't worry me at all. I'd like you to know, questions like that.
Thank you for calling. This word. Statement in words.